once again, closing out here, I know we've talked about the emergency services in our county, and I find them extremely important for not only medical, but fire and rescue. And it's like an insurance policy that we always put money into for automobiles and everything else, our houses. We hope we never use it. But by gosh, I'm very helpful and grateful that it's sitting there just in case I do need it. And it's our responsibility to make sure we respond to this emergency as we're going. And of course, there's sort of the three things that are really primary in our upcoming budget, you know, the fire services and medical, schools and education, transportation, roads, et cetera. All these things are important to our community. And we start next week for an almost a 7-month process of getting our budget together. It's a long process, but we work diligently on it to make sure we provide the best services we can for our people. And that's what we're here for. And we will look at it closely. It's going to be a hard time coming up. We understand that as this COVID is continually hitting at us. And I'm not optimistic that it's going to go away in a few months. That's just the way it is. So, and getting also to this flooding that we had on 4 August, I can only experience that my own home that I've been living in 20 years, I've never seen anything like it. We had over 11 inches of rain in downtown Columbus. The creeks and everything around it were unbelievable flooding. The pond behind my house is called Ledford Pond. It rose 5.5 feet. Normally, the edge of it is 200 feet from my house. It came within 80 feet of my house. The stream that runs alongside my property is normally 8 feet of a stream bed. It turned into over 100 yards wide of water rushing down almost 2 feet deep. I couldn't believe it. And of course, for the first time ever, my basement flooded. And I'm rushing around outside, treading in this muddy water in the rain, getting a small generator together to hook up to my sump pump. Because we had lost electricity from SMETCO for almost 8 hours. We had lost electricity. So everything went wrong, totally wrong in everything here. But I think there's hard to plan for something like this, even every 10 years, which we have a plan now to look every 10 years at working on stormwater management and things like that. To say 100 years is probably ridiculous to even think about that because it just changes that much. And it's changed a lot the last few years. So I would say to everybody, we've learned from this, and we're probably going to establish contact with those that are in these floodplain areas that have been identified to either evacuate, to let you know that we may not be able to get you to one of these severe floods. You have to be aware of this and pay attention to get out when you're told to. Like any big storm, get out and protect yourself. Life is more valuable than property. I'm sorry, we can replace property. We're placing everything in my basement now, and I'm happy with that. I'm glad I had insurance to help me out. Flu shots, my gosh, yes, you need it more than ever now. With this COVID-19 on top of the flu season, get your flu shot as soon as you can. It's very important because now I'm confused which one I should do. Should I go get another one or not? But anyway, I'll stick with the needle one right now.